TomoNews presents 3D printing.
A 3D-printed plastic cast, dubbed the Cortex Exoskeleton, is a finalist for the 2013 James Dyson Award. Widely used traditional orthopedic casts are bulky and inconvenient. X-ray scans of the breaks in the bone allow the Cortex Exoskeleton to be printed to fit exactly over the affected limb, with an extra membrane over the point of injury. The technology is waterproof, allowing wearers to wash even with the cast on. The design allows the limb to breathe, and wearers can scratch and itch even while wearing the cast. The cast is also thin and flexible enough that clothes can be worn over it. The winner of the International Student Design Award will be announced within a week.
Amsterdam to get the world's first 3D-printed pedestrian bridge. A Dutch startup company has announced plans to draw a steel structure over water in Amsterdam. Dutch company MX3D plans to print a bridge across an Amsterdam canal, with the project set to begin in September. The computer program plots designs while robotic arms heat metal to 1,500 degrees Celsius, around 2,700 degrees Fahrenheit, to weld structures drop by drop. This technique removes the need for scaffolding and people, as the robotic arms are supported by the very structure they are printing. This essentially means robotic arms will walk across the canal as a bridge is being created. According to the company, this technique could become standard on future construction projects, especially on high-rise structures that are more dangerous for human builders. MIT researchers create 3D-printed robot skin. These robot cubes are wearing MIT's latest creation. Researchers at MIT have developed 3D-printed skin for robots. The skin protects robots and helps make their movements more precise. The skin is made of a programmable viscoelastic material. Unlike purely elastic substances, a viscoelastic substance has an elastic component and a viscous component. Viscoelastics are able to dissipate or dampen energy where elastics cannot. Through 3D printing, the skin's elasticity can be manipulated by altering the amount of liquid material inside. A solid, a liquid, and a flexible rubber-like material called Tango Black Plus were used in the printing process during testing. When tested on bouncing robots, the creations with more liquid-concentrated skin bounced higher and landed with more precision. The work was supported by a grant from the National Science Foundation.
New Zealand joins the space race. Test launches for a commercial space rocket built by a startup based both in Los Angeles and New Zealand are scheduled to take place this week. The Rocket Lab Electron is made of carbon composite material, and its rocket boosters use 3D-printed Rutherford engines. The rocket's first stage has a cluster of 9 electric engines that burn liquid oxygen and refined kerosene. The second stage has a single vacuum-optimized engine that can carry payloads weighing up to 225 kilograms. The Electron rocket will deliver small satellites into space. They will be used for mapping, to predict the weather, provide high-speed internet, and analyze the environment. Rocket Lab plans to complete 3 test launches before the Electron is available commercially. The company plans to eventually build and launch 1 rocket per week, with flights costing around $5 million each.
San Diego-based company Organovo has developed a bioprinter that is making strips of liver tissue that could be used to test new drugs before they're administered to humans. One of the two printer's syringes is filled with spheroids containing parenchymal liver cells, which are used to assess the potential toxicity or efficacy of drugs. The second syringe contains bio-ink with non-parenchymal liver cells, which bolster cellular development, and a hydrogel that helps with extrusion. A computer connected to the printer instructs a robotic arm that moves the syringe to print a mold in a honeycomb pattern. A small sensor then determines the location of the first syringe. Then parenchymal cells are added to the well plate mold. Once the different cells are mixed, the well plate is placed into an incubator where they continue fusing until they eventually form the complex matrix of a liver tissue. According to Organovo's website, the ultimate goal of studies like these is to develop living, multicellular human tissues that can be maintained in laboratories for both functional and histological changes in response to injury, pathogens, or treatments.
3D-printed organ on a chip could end animal testing. Harvard scientists have developed a 3D-printed heart on a computer chip, which can be used to study heart conditions without testing medical treatments on animals. The heart on a chip is composed of a small piece of flexible polymer that contains living human heart cells, which can mimic the physiological response of a human heart. The chip also contains integrated sensors. The sensors collect data on the beating of the heart on a chip, which can be used to study how the tissue responds to drugs or toxins. Other organs, including bones, lungs, the liver, and gut, can also be made into organs on a chip. Backers of the technology say it is a more accurate alternative to testing drugs on animals and hope it can decrease the number of animals used for testing.
A technology that can produce lithium-ion microbatteries with 3D printers has been developed by Harvard scientist Jennifer Lewis. To make the ink, nanoparticles of lithium titanium oxide are added to a vial of deionized water and ethylene glycol. Ceramic balls are used as agitators to break down the particles. The mixture is spun for 24 hours. The balls and larger particles are removed with filters and a centrifuge. The resulting ink is placed in a syringe and inserted into a high-pressure dispenser on a 3D printer. The ink is solid when unperturbed, but flows under high pressure. The ink is printed on a glass substrate with a gold current collector, where it solidifies to create the battery's anode and cathode. A tiny container filled with an electrolyte solution encloses the electrodes to complete the battery. The printed battery is about 1 millimeter square. The batteries could be used in miniaturized medical implants, compact electronics, and tiny robots. The technology is still at an early stage, but the ability to print batteries and other electronics could make it possible to manufacture new kinds of small devices.
Now we can make glass with a 3D printer. A group of German researchers have developed a new method for making glass with 3D printing technology. The 3D printed glass is made from a mixture of glass nanoparticles and a photocurable liquid, which acts as a binding agent. Through a method known as stereolithography, the mixture is shaped and hardened after exposure to UV light. Any remaining liquid is burnt away by high heat, which further fuses the glass nanoparticles together. Researchers say the 3D printed glass can be used for anything from building skyscraper facades to camera lenses for smartphones.
The American Dental Association recommends that people brush their teeth at least 3 to 4 times each day. But now, a company called Blizzardent is marketing a device of the same name it says can achieve the same results in only 6 seconds. A dentist first makes an impression of a patient's teeth using the same technique used to mold braces. The company then uses a 3D printer to make a customized mouthguard based on the mold. Each device contains 400 bristles, which are fitted onto the mouthguard at a 45 degree angle. Instead of brushing, users bite and grind their teeth on the brush. This action enables the bristles to get to difficult to reach regions. The handle doubles as a floss dispenser. The device also has a built-in tongue scraper. Blizzardent claims its device can clean the teeth in places handheld toothbrushes can't reach. The Blizzardent costs $299 and must be replaced once a year.
US space agency NASA is funding a company to develop 3D printing of foods. Advocates of 3D printing technology say delivering long-life foods from alternative ingredients could help solve the problem of feeding astronauts and ease food shortages on Earth. Manned space missions require stocks of non-perishable foods. 3D printing could be a promising solution to the problem of feeding crews. Traditionally, food sources perish easily. Proteins, vitamins, fibers, and carbohydrates can be derived from alternative nutrient sources like insects, grasses, algae, and seeds. Stored as powders, they can last for years. When combined with sugars and oils, nutritionally dense foods can be created layer by layer. NASA will provide U.S. firm Anjan Contractor with $125,000 over 6 months to make the technology viable. 3D printing is already used to build complex machine parts and furniture.